News every 15 minutes, weather every 10, and sports twice an hour.
News Talk KGVO, AM 1290 and 98.3 FM.
You're listening to Montana Morning with Peter Christian.
State of Montana bracing for even more budget cuts. Good morning, everyone. Montana Morning for Thursday, August 31st, 2017. Not officially the end of summer, but it's certainly the end of August as September gets started tomorrow. It is smoky and 61 degrees. There is an air quality alert and a red flag warning for western Montana. Of course, air quality has been bad because of the fires. And the red flag warning means a chance of thunderstorms and strong winds, especially in those areas that have been affected by fire. Our newscast this morning, sponsored by Diggett Excavating, bringing 30 years of excellence to every job. Call 214-4292. One of our top stories this morning, Montana Governor Steve Bullock's budget director says the state will have a $227 million budget shortfall by 2019 unless government agencies further cut spending to make up the difference. Dan Villa said he directed agencies yesterday to submit plans to cut their budgets by 10%. The cuts will not occur for at least a month while the proposals are being reviewed. The new spending reductions would come on top of cuts that were already triggered this month by low revenue results and additional cuts made last spring by state lawmakers in the 2018-2019 budget. Even with the previous cuts, Villa said the state's expected to be $84 million in the hole by 2019. The state is required by law to have a cash reserve of at least $143 million by the end of the two-year budget cycle. Lolo National Forest spokesman Boyd Hartwig is defending the actions taken to manage the Lolo Peak fire when it was first reported back on July 15th. Now that the fire has burned over 38,000 acres, destroyed two homes, and tragically taken the life of a California firefighter, and has become what could be the most expensive fire in Montana history, Hartwig responded to critics who asked why there wasn't a more aggressive response when the fire was smaller and possibly easier to control.
Respond to which were fires in like the immediate urban interface area that were potentially imminently threatening structures.
Hartwig said fire officials are always learning from every incident.
We always are looking for ways to assess and put resources where we can be most effective, and that's an ongoing thing. And I think every day we learn. So the question is yes to we are learning, but it's also the answer is also yes that we feel like we did the right thing here.
Fire officials say it'll take a season-ending event to put out the Lolo Peak fire. Three young Ravalli County men recently accepted a plea agreement for felony and misdemeanor negligent arson in the Roaring Lion fire of last summer. But that agreement has come under fire by some in the area. Ravalli County Attorney Bill Fulbright said the evidence presented did not show any criminal intent by the defendants. He explained the terms of the plea agreement.
For each of the next 5 years, they're going to pay 10% of their adjusted gross income each year. And then the second thing is community service. We've asked the Forest Service to direct that community service, but they've agreed to each perform 300 hours of community service.
Fulbright said his office has received criticism regarding the plea deals.
There is certainly a group of landowners who have provided some blowback that say that is too soft, that's not enough, that there should be harsher consequences. There's also groups of victims, landowners, that believe nothing should have been done to the individuals, to the point of questioning, why am I singling out these three when they really did nothing that is different from most people that go camping up in the mountains?
Fulbright said insurance companies and private citizens can pursue restitution in civil court if they choose, but he hasn't personally heard of any such actions yet. An infrared flight earlier this week shows that the Rice Ridge fire near Seeley Lake has burned through 32,000 acres. Fire Information Officer Sarah Rouse says it's also displaced 1,000 homes. The bad news continues as the area is now under a red flag warning.
The order that was issued Monday evening affected 1,028 different address points. And there's a red flag warning that's going to be in effect until 9 p.m. today. And with that, we're expecting extremely low humidities as well as some unstable wind patterns that would be associated with some thunder cells that would be moving through the area.
Rouse describes the area where the fire is closest to homes.
Well, it depends on which area of the fire you're at, but it's about less than half a mile from that northern end of the section with the airport in it. It's getting fairly close. There's folks that are working on that line, and they've been able to hold that really well. There wasn't much growth on that at all yesterday evening.
The price tag so far for fighting the The Rice Ridge fire is up over $23.5 million. The issue of allowing author Jon Krakauer access to confidential student records of former Grizzly quarterback Jordan Johnson has been returned to state court. Associate Commissioner of Higher Education Kevin McCray explains.
The court ruled that the case should be remanded to state district court for that court to perform exactly what the university system and the commissioner's office had hoped the court would do all along, and that is review the complete file of records so the court can then determine what records, if any, should be provided.
McCray said the University of Montana risks the loss of federal funding if they illegally turn over confidential student records.
The student privacy law says that we cannot release student records, that you then risk federal funding of the institution. So that means if, as the Supreme Court ruled, it is a real threat of public funding where we could no longer accept Pell Grants. We could no longer accept federal student financial aid that helps get students in the door.
Krakauer's book, Missoula, Rape and the Justice System in a College Town, partially dealt with his attempt to see Johnson's student records. And the red flag warning continues in western Montana due to the series of thunderstorms combined with strong winds. Meteorologist Leanne Allegretto said today's main threat will be those winds.
We'll start to notice a little drop in temperatures as the cold front comes through, but the most noticeable thing will be the gusty winds. So all day long, we're expecting west, southwest winds to increase. It may be more noticeable in the mid to higher terrain, which is also not good for wildfires, but some of that will translate down into valleys. So a pretty breezy day overall across the region all day Thursday.
Fire officials are watching the weather closely to determine if any new fires get started or existing fires are blown past their containment lines. Our News Talk time is 6:12.
News Talk, KGVO.
Missoula's official weather station.
Smoky sunshine today with our high temperatures in the mid-80s. Winds will be out of the southwest at 5 to 15 miles per hour. It will remain breezy tonight into your Friday, but warmer weather and dry skies through the weekend. I'm meteorologist Brooke Foster for Missoula's KECI 13.